Welcome to Meet Your Local Heroes, a series of talented speakers in Charlotte, North Carolina. You'll meet specialists in health, finance, change management, sales, and more. Let's join our host, Phil Earhart, and meet this episode's local hero.
Welcome to Meet Your Local Heroes, a show about some of the most talented speakers in the Charlotte area. Joining us today is Leah Marone. Hello, Leah. Welcome to Meet Your Local Heroes.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Let's learn a little bit more about Leah. She is a psychotherapist who specializes in anxiety, depression, grief or trauma, and sports psychology. Now, currently, Leah works with individuals and families at her practice here in Charlotte, North Carolina. However, she is also sought out by corporations and organizations to work with executives and teams on issues around mental health, improving productivity, and building resiliency. So, Leah, now that we know what you do, tell us why you do this.
Great question. So, my big why is to generate self-awareness. I love to create space for people to learn more about themselves and basically to get out of any form of stagnation that they're currently in. The human mind has always fascinated me. And really, if you dig deep enough, our patterns, our behaviors, and why we are, why we act, and maybe feel the way we do, generally make sense.
That's interesting. Yeah, the human mind is a wonderful thing. I didn't mention this previously in your bio, but you're pretty much a sports enthusiast. Where did that come from?
So I play Division I basketball at Ball State in Indiana, and I was also a big soccer player. So sports were a big part of just growing up, and I was always on teams. And I actually suffered quite a bit from performance anxiety. So lived through that and love working with athletes now and even professionals that have kind of performance anxiety in other ways, whether it's speaking or leading, presenting, what have you, on just that anxiety piece that goes along with all that. So it's definitely something that I lived, and it's definitely something now that I'm extremely passionate about.
So if an organization is looking for a speaker for their event or a workshop, what types of organizations are you looking to help?
Sure. So I mainly talk about topics generally around self-awareness, building resiliency, things that you mentioned, and that can be applicable to anyone on whatever level. So a lot of times I work with sales teams, I work with organizations that, like most, productivity is a huge goal, as it should be. But a lot of times where I focus and help them focus is really taking care of their people and individually taking care of their people and generating that self-awareness, that support, so that we can prevent burnout, people can do what they're supposed to do, build the connection, and also build more of just a team-oriented and goal-oriented situation where people actually like showing up to work. So when companies come to me, we really hone in on what's gonna work best for them, where their deficits are. And I do a lot of wellness workshops and then small group processing groups or Q&As to just, again, generate that self-awareness, provide tips on work-life balance and building that resilience, and also how to take time to reflect, regroup, and learn from our patterns that we all have and ones that sometimes aren't serving us very well.
So without naming names, can you give us an example of how you helped an organization?
So I worked with a sales team recently that had about 150 people. And the way that we structured that was I gave an hour presentation that had a lot of activities that people could do. It was a virtual event, so a lot of people could do from their home that they could individualize for themselves. The main topics were stress and anxiety, coping with working from home, again, transitioning and all that work-life balance, and basically a lot of the grief associated with what the pandemic has brought on. And so a lot of it was educational piece there in the beginning. But the important piece, I think, was the week after, we broke everybody up into smaller processing groups of about 8 to 10 people. And that's when a lot of the magic happened. That's when people could come with their individual questions. That's when they could be validated by their peers. That's when I could spend more time with them. And it was just an intimate setting. So it was really interesting to hear they kind of absorbed the knowledge, applied it to them, and then we could come back and really identify what supports they could create for themselves and their teams moving forward. And I always like to follow those up with emails, maybe bi-weekly, on just, again, reiterating tips and reiterating some things that people can do to generate that presence work, that mindfulness work, and to continue building positive habits for not only them, but then for their teams, which in turn creates a higher level of productivity and just employee engagement.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful. So tell me, what type of presentation style? What's your presentation style?
My presentation style, again, I really tailor it to what companies need. I have a few companies that just want me to pop in every week and lead a Q&A. And people will ask me questions and that works for them. And it's very laid back. My presentation style overall is I really want to understand my audience and kind of the room, if you will. So if I can tell right off the bat that I'm going to have a very engaging audience, I'll work with that. I love that. That generates that, you know, that self-awareness, that generates that learning, and people are included. I do a lot of activities. I do a lot of case examples. I do a lot of, I don't just list off basically like, try this. I will basically preface that with exercises that people understand why they're operating the way they're operating and some things that they can do that's tailored to them and for them to take ownership, because that's when people actually will start to make the shift.
Well, that's awesome. Well, thank you very much for your time and joining us today on Meet Your Local Heroes. I do appreciate you taking the time for us.
Well, thank you so much. It's my pleasure.
If you would like to schedule Leah Moreau or any of our other local heroes for your next event, contact Hey Red Speakers Agency or visit the website at heyred.biz. We appreciate you taking the time to watch and meet your local heroes. Click the subscribe button so you'll know when new local hero interviews are added. For Meet Your Local Heroes, I'm Phil Ehrhardt. Go out and make it a wonderful day today.